Are you able to see the screen? Chapter at a glance?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, reflection of light. You can see here the important points I am going to discuss now. So in this chapter, we have to start with the reflection of light. So what is reflection? A ray of light incident. After incident, on a boundary separating two medium, comes back to the same media, is called reflection. So here it is incidenting and reflecting back. Here what are the important points here? The angle of incidence I, the angle of reflection R. This light ray you can call it as the incident ray. This is reflected ray. And perpendicular to this reflecting surface, this is the smooth reflecting surface. Perpendicular to this reflecting surface you can call it as the normal. So in this we have three important points: incident ray, reflected ray, and normal. Okay, and reflecting surface. Reflecting surface example is plane mirror. Example is plane mirror. So incident ray, reflected ray, refracted ray, all are lie on the same plane. So that is the vertical plane. Okay, that plane is referred as a plane of incidence. That plane you can refer as plane of incidence. Are you clear this point? And angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Angle I is equal to angle R. Are you able to hear? Yes. Sweta?
Yes.
Yeah, very good. Next, after reflection, what happened? Velocity, wavelength, and frequency of light remain same, but intensity only decreases. After reflection of light, what will changes you can expect? Only intensity will be changes or decreases. Velocity, wavelength, frequency of light remains no change. Okay. Next, if the light ray incident normally on a surface, after reflection, it retraces its path. So that means if it is incident like this, along the normal, like this, then after reflection, what you can expect? It will go back like this. That means it will deviate by an angle 180 degree. Okay, that is called a retracing. It will retrace its path. Okay. So that is a deviation observed is 180 degree. Normally the deviation is like this. So this is the incident direction. So your angle of incidence is I. Then this is the reflected ray. Then this much is the angle of deviation, D, let us say. Then angle D is equal to actually, you can see here, 180 minus I plus R. Angle I plus angle R. So that is the angle of deviation, 180 minus I plus R. So here I is equal to R normally, we know, according to loss of reflection. So that 180 minus 2i or 180 minus 2r. But in the case of normal incidence, I equal to 0, r is equal to 0. Then deviation is 180 degree. Then the deviation is 180 degree. Okay. Next point, if the light rays after reflection or refraction intersect at a point, then a real image is formed and even they appear to meet. Okay. So if the light rays after reflection or refraction, suppose if the reflected light rays intersect at a point, then the real image will be formed. Suppose you can imagine like this, there are two light rays. One is light ray like this. Suppose another light ray here like this, they intersect at this point after reflection. So this is point P, point of intersection. Then this point, a real image will be formed. Okay. Suppose if they not really intersect, they are appearing to meet. Okay, if they are appearing to meet instead of meeting, then virtual image is formed. Real image means the reflected ray should intersect. Virtual image means appears to intersect. Okay, next. If the rays are converging, then the object is virtual. The rays are diverging, Okay, then it is real. See here, these letters are taken like this. This is the mirror, and then the letters are coming. So this is a converging letters. That means meet at a point. Then object is virtual. The rays are diverging. Okay. So that means from a point object letters are coming like this, going away, diverging. In that case, the object is real. This is about important points regarding reflection in the case of converging and diverging. Next, you can see plane mirrors. The image formed by a plane mirror is virtual, erect, laterally inverted, equal in size of that of the object and are at a distance equal to the distance of the object from the plane mirror. What is the nature of the image formed by the plane mirror here? The nature of the image formed by the plane mirror is virtual, erect, laterally inverted, equal in size that of the object and at a distance equal to distance of the object in front of the mirror. That means suppose you have a object here. This is the mirror. So it will form an image here, let us say. Okay, so here this image is virtual image and erect, that means same side, and laterally inverted, that means like this, opposite laterally. Equal in size. Size of the image is equal to size of the object. And the distance. The distance of the object should be equal to distance of the image. This is the important points related to the nature of the image. In case of plane mirror. If a plane mirror is rotated in the plane of incidence through an angle theta by keeping the incident ray fixed, then the reflected ray rotated through an angle 2 theta. Suppose if the plane mirror is rotated through an angle theta like this. Suppose initially plane mirror is like this. After that, this is the normal. After that, it is rotated like this by theta angle. Then by keeping incident ray, so let us say incident ray like this. Then reflected ray will be rotated like this by an angle to theta. That means with respect to initial reflected ray to final reflected ray, this rotation will be 2 theta. This is the point. Okay. Are you able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Right. When two plane mirrors are inclined at each other at an angle theta, like this. These are two plane mirrors. The angle of inclination is theta. Then the number of images formed of an object which is kept between them is if number of images we need to calculate by taking this ratio 360 by theta is even integer. That means this theta, let us suppose 30 degree, then 360 by 30. Okay, so that is 12. So that is even. In that case, number of images formed is n is equal to 360 by theta minus 1. That is 12 minus 1. That is 11. Okay. So like this. Suppose if it is 60 degree, like that each and every case we can check. If a ratio 360 by this theta angle between two mirrors is even integer, the number of images is that 360 by theta minus 1. So if 360 by theta is odd integer, then there are two possibilities. If object is placed symmetrically, then n is equal to 360 by theta minus 1. If object is placed asymmetrically, that is 360 by theta. Odd integer means suppose theta 120 degree, then 360 by 120. Okay, this is 3. So 3 is odd integer. Then in that case, if it is angle 120, then the object is placed symmetrically means this is the line of symmetry. You can see here, this is the line. So on this line, you can place the object anywhere. Then the number of images is again 360 by theta minus 1. That means 3 minus 1, 2. In the case of 120. Suppose other than this line, you can take this side or this side. Then the number of images will be, even though 120 degree, object position is changed. Then object asymmetrically can place. Then number of images is 3 system by theta. That is equal to 3. Okay. So this is about conditions for number of images formed. Next, when object moves with a speed u towards or away from the plane mirror, then image also moves towards or away from the mirror with a speed u. That means if the object is moving with a speed u, then image also will move with the same speed u. Okay. With respect to the mirror. That means object is moving away with the u, then image also moving away with the speed u. And the relative speed of image with respect to object is 2u. Now, speed of image, v image with respect to an object. That means vi minus vu, relative velocity method. But angle between these two, 180 degree, opposite direction. Then you can take magnitude vi bar minus vu bar. Magnitude you can take vi plus vu. Okay, velocity of image plus velocity of object. You know how it is. Yesterday in relative velocity concept we discussed. Theta 180, this vector value addition vi plus vu. That will become 2u. Are you clear this point? The relative speed of image with respect to object is 2u.
Yes, sir.
Next, when a plane mirror moves towards a stationary object with a speed u, then the image will move with a speed 2u. Now you can take plane mirror. Mirror is moving with a speed u. Then the image will move with a speed 2u. Why? Because you can see here. So but this is the object O. This is the mirror. This is the image I. Suppose let us say distance x, object distance from the mirror, then the image distance also x, no doubt. Now mirror is displaced through some d distance towards object. Mirror is moved d distance, you can see here. So that what happened, the distance from the object to the mirror will become x minus d. This is the initial position, now is the final position. D decreased. Now in the image side you can see, image side, here this D decreased. This initial position is at a distance of x. Okay. Now, this x minus D, suppose this object is fixed. D distance image is, mirror is moved towards object. Then the image is shifted, you can see here. Because of this D. Okay. So this is missed here. 2D distance will be missed. Initial position, suppose you can imagine 10 meters. The number you can understand very easily. Suppose 5 meters, initial position, image how much? 10 meters. Initial position of the object is 10 meters from the mirror, image also 10 meters. Now suppose, let us say some 2 meters is decreased. That means towards object, the mirror is moved 2 meters. Then the remaining is 8 meters. Now distance from the object to the mirror is 8 meters. Okay. Now you can see with respect to this position, the image also shifted now. Image also shifted. How much it will shift? Again, what is the final image distance? 8 meters. 8 meters. Now in the previous case, how much distance? This 10 meters is there and 2 meters separated. 2 meters. Come forward, then total distance 12 meters. Are you clear this point? Initially 10 meters from the mirror to image, because of the shifting of the mirror, total virtual is 12 meters. But after forming image, it is reduced to 8 meters. That means from 12 to 8 meters, it is came. Are you clear this point? Yes or no? It came to 12 to 8 meters. That means how much it is decreased? Two times of, na? Say 2 meters is shifted, but the loss, the differential came is 4 meters. That means if d meters it is moved, then the 2d meters will be difference we can observe. I recall this point, all of you. Yes or no? Plane mirror moving a distance d, then the image is moved 2d distance. With respect to new position, 2D difference came, 2D times of distance. Understood or not? Then the time rate of distance, D by T, let us say U, that is the mirror speed. Then the image speed will become 2D by T, 2 times of D by T, that is 2U. You can see here, if the mirror moves towards stationary object speed u, then the image will move with the speed 2u. Are you understood now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, like that. A man height h requires a plane mirror of length at least equal to h by 2. That means a man of height h requires a plane mirror to see his complete image. Half of that height is required, h by 2. That is the point. Next, a reflection of light by spherical mirrors. So, spherical mirror is a part of a transparent hollow sphere whose one surface is polished. Okay, you have to take a sphere with a polished one side. Reflecting surface is depressed and bulged base and is silvered, then known as concave. So, that means the surface should be like this. Okay, it's a depressed and then silvered bulged side. Like this. Silvered means a shed coating. That is the concave. The reflecting surface is bulged and depressed side is silvered. That means like this. Bulged side is reflecting, inner side is, this is coated. That means so you can keep some paint or something silvering in it to do. So this is the reflecting surface. This is the reflecting surface. So this is the concave. This is the convex. Okay, convex, concave, mirrors. Now, for paraxial rays, f is equal to r by 2 relation. Your f is the focal length, r is the radius of curvature. Then the relation between f and r is f is equal to r by 2. Okay, or r is equal to 2f, relation between focal length and radius of curvature. Next, power is the length, power of a lens. Power is the ability of a mirror of converging or diverging to incident ray after reflection. Power of the mirror is the ability to converge or diverge of an incident ray after reflection. Okay. Next, aperture. It is the effective diameter of a reflecting area. Light reflecting area. This reflecting area here, it is there now. This is the aperture. This area. You can say aperture. Aperture of the mirror. Next, intensity or a brightness of image. The intensity of the light, reflecting light, or brightness of the image proportional to square of the aperture. It's proportional to square of the aperture. That means aperture is bigger, the intensity or brightness of the image is more. This is the square of aperture. Mirror formula. You know already this, 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. 1 by u plus 1 by v is equal to 1 by f. It's the important formula, provided u is the object distance, v is the image distance, okay, and f is the focal length. And all the distance are measured from the pole of the mirror. So you have like this, concave mirror. This is the principal axis. This point you can call it as the pole. Then you can keep the object here. This is the u, object distance. Then somewhere image is formed. Then this is the image distance. focal length. All the laterals, the point where all the laterals are converging, they meet, reflected laterals, that is called focus. And the distance from focus to pole is called focal length. Okay. Next, magnification. When the object is placed perpendicular to the principal axis, like this, the linear magnification is called lateral or transverse magnification. So mathematically, this magnification is equal to ratio of size of the image to size of the object, or height of the image to height of the object. Take like HI by HO, height of the image by height of the object. That is equal to minus V by U. This is the formula. Minus V image distance by object distance. Y is the size of the object. I is the size of the image. You can see here, size of the image by size of the object they taken. They taken as the I and O. You can take height of the image to height of the object also. Are you clear this? Yes or no? My dear students.
Yes, sir.
Yes. The object is lies along the principal axis. And the longitude lies along the principal axis is like this case. This is the principal axis. The object is placed like this, parallel to principal axis. Then in that case, magnification you can take size of the image by size of the object as equal to minus of V2 minus V1. That means image distance. Image distance, initial position, final position is there now. So with respect to this point U1, with respect to this point U2. These are the object distances. Then image is formed somewhere here. Then this is with respect to final position V1, this position V2. Generate V2 minus V1 by U2 minus V1, the ratio. Next, if object is small, you can take directly delta V, minus delta V or dV, dV by dU. Then minus dV by dU will get as V by U whole square. How we will get? Very simple. You can see 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F now. Differentiate this with respect to partially. Minus 1 by V square dV. Minus 1 by U square dU. If F is no change, that is 0. Then you get minus 1 by V square dV is equal to plus 1 by U square dU. Then you get dV by dU is equal to minus of V square by U square. Like this you will get. Then minus dV by dU plus V square by U square. Okay. So that dV minus dV by dU is equal to plus V by U whole square. Next, a planar object is placed with the plane perpendicular to the principal axis. A planar object placed with its plane perpendicular to axis. Then magnification is given by, that means like a object with some plane like this, some area. That is called planar object. In that case, magnification you can do area of the image by area of the object. Magnification you can do area of the image by area of the object. Then this area you can write like, see, area, suppose this length A, breadth B. Then magnification of area, M times of A. Magnification of breadth, M times of B, divided by initial area AB. Initial area what? A into B. Okay, then finally magnified linearly. Length M times of A, breadth M times of B. Then MA into MB by AB. AB, AB cancel, M square. That means surface magnification is equal to square of the linear magnification. That is the point you have to understand. Next, sign convention. You can see here, this is the lens or mirror you can take, this vertical line. Above you can take positive, below negative. Left side you can take negative, right side positive. This is the principal axis. This is the incident ray direction. Now, how the sign convention you can see here? All the distances are measured from the pole. So this is the pole point. The distance should be taken from the pole. Light is assumed to be coming from left to towards the mirror. So from left, light is coming towards the mirror or lens. The distance are measured in the direction of incident ray taken as positive. So along the incident ray direction, you can take measurement of distance that is positive. While the opposite to the incident ray direction taken as negative. That means suppose you have a, let us say, point of object here. Then from pole, you are going opposite to incident ray. This is the object distance minus u. Okay, negative, that's why. U will be negative. Suppose here, this is the image somewhere here it is formed. Then the from the pole, the direction of the measurement you have taken along the incident ray, that is the v, that is positive, means distance. Okay, then the distance is above the principal axis taken as positive. Above this point, above the principal axis taken as positive values. And below the principal axis, this direction taken as negative. Okay. Are you clear this sign convention, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Concave mirror is used for shaving mirror. Example, shaving mirror you can use. Concave mirror. Searchlight, cinema projector, telescope, ENT surgeons, they are using concave mirrors, dentists. Next, convex mirror used for road lamps. That means a rear view mirror in the vehicles. Backside, rear, back view. The driver used back view mirror. That is about a convex mirror. Next, refraction of light. The deviation of the light ray from its actual path when passing from one medium to another medium is called refraction. The deviation of light from its actual path when it is passing from one medium to another medium is called refraction. That means you can imagine like this. This is the medium. This is the normal. The light ray incident like this. So this is one medium one. This is medium two. Then we'll passing to another medium. Instead of going like this, actual direction, it is changing either towards the normal or away from the normal. This is a deviation of light from its original path when passing from one medium to another medium is called refraction. The refraction of light takes place going from one medium to another medium because of the speed of the light is different in the two media. Okay, because of the mediums are optically rarer, optically denser, so that the speed of light changes, so that the light ray path also deviates or changes. Okay, this is the important point. Because of the speed of light changes, a medium in which the speed of light increases is known as the optically rarer medium. That means when the denser to rarer is coming light, the speed of light will be increases. And the medium in which speed of light decreases is known as optically denser medium. Suppose the light is coming from a rarer to denser, the speed of light will be decreases. Normally in denser medium, speed decreases. In rarer medium, speed increases. The degree of refraction of any medium is known as refractive index. The degree of refraction in any medium is known as refractive index of that medium. That is named with N or symbol mu. Mu or N. When the light ray goes from a rarer medium to denser medium, it bending towards the normal. So if it is rarer to denser, what I have given diagram, bending towards the normal. If it is denser to rarer, bending away from the normal, like this. Bending away from the normal. Loss of reflection is given by Snell's law. The product of sine of the angle of incident to the sine of the product of angle of ray with the normal to under refractive index is constant. That means so n into sine theta is constant. Or else we can say ratio of sine of the angle of incidence to angle of refraction is equal to constant. That is equal to refractive index. Sine A by sine R is equal to n. That is Snell's law. For two media, Snell's law you can write as n2 by n1 is equal to sine A by sine R from one medium to another medium. Suppose you can take medium 1, N1, this is N2. In that case, light ray coming like this with angle of incidence I, and this is angle of refraction R. Then you can take sin A by sin R is equal to N2 by N1. That means from an opposite medium to first medium, you should take ratio. The minimum value of absolute refractive index is 1. This mu value minimum 1. For air, it is equal to 1, nearly, 1.003. If a light ray travels from medium 1 to medium 2, then N21 is equal to N2 by N1. relative refraction index n2 with respect to 1, that is n2 by n1, that is equal to lambda 1 by lambda 2, that is equal to v1 by v2 speed. Okay, that means when the light passing from one medium to another medium, only frequency f will not change, except that remaining all will be changes when it is passing from one medium to another medium. So that ratio of refraction index you can take n2 by n1, you can define as lambda 1 by lambda 2, that is equal to v1 by v2, the speed ratio of the speeds. Okay, refraction index decreases with increase of temperature. That means refraction index change depends on the temperature. Next, when the object is in a denser medium and observer is in rarer medium, then refraction index of denser medium with respect to rarer medium is n is equal to real depth by apparent depth. That means you can have like a water. Water is a denser medium compared to air. Then inside there is an object. Okay, this observer is looking this object from the air, that means from the rarer medium. Then in that case, this is like a real depth, let us say H depth or D depth. But with respect to the observer, it is showing apparent depth. Then apparent depth is equal to A depth, apparent depth is equal to real depth by mu, real depth by refraction index L. This is the formula. When the observer is looking the object, object is in denser medium, so that you can able to see only apparent depth. Apparent depth is equal to real depth by refraction index. That means you can able to see. Suppose there is a swimming pool, there is a person inside. Suppose let us say some 10 meter depth is there. But the observer on the top of the swimming pool on the side, he can able to see he is at a depth of 10 by water refraction index 1.33. Okay, that is 10 by, you can say 4 by 3. So that is 30 by 4. Okay, so that apparent depth is really is in 10 meter depth, but he can able to, the observer able to see only he is in at a depth of 7.5 meters, approximately at a 7.5 meters. Are you clear this? Yes or no? Relation between real depth and apparent depth. Next, when an object is in rarer medium and observer is in denser medium, then refraction index of the rarer medium with respect to denser medium is, then again n is equal to h dash by h. Observer is in denser medium, then in that case apparent depth how to take, or apparent height. Say observer is in denser medium, that is say observer inside the water, like a fish inside the water looking the bird. This is the actual height of the bird, h. But with respect to the observer inside the water, observer can able to see at apparent height of h dash is equal to n times of h. So that means the bird is at a distance of 10 meters, but observer can able to see at a height of n times of h. N means 4 by 3 times of h, 10. Okay, that means 40 by 3. Are you clear? That is around 13 meter distance. That is the apparent height. Are you able to following apparent depth and apparent height? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Apparent height is equal to refraction index times of real height, apparent depth is equal to refractive index divided by, sorry, real depth divided by refractive index. Then refraction through glass slab. Okay, the refracting surfaces of the glass slab parallel to each other. When the light passes through the glass slab, it is refracted twice at the two parallel faces and finally emerges out parallel to incident direction. That is, the ray undergoes no deviation. This is the important point. When the light passes from one side of the glass slab to other slab, first it is refracted while entering into glass slab. That means from rarer to denser. How much bend? It will bend towards the normal. Again, it will come out. It will go away from the normal. Incident ray is parallel to emerging ray. That means the deviation is zero. That means whatever deviation suffered in the first refraction, in a clockwise sense, that deviation will be comes back in a anti-clockwise sense. So that net deviation is zero. And the angle of emergence equal to angle of incidence. Angle of emergence is equal to angle of incidence. But only there is a shift. This is the shift. Shift of the light ray. That shift is called lateral shift. The ray is perpendicular to the distance between the incident and emergent ray. Lateral shift is the perpendicular distance between incident ray and emerging ray. You can see at this distance d, there is the lateral shift. It is given by this value. T secant r into sin I minus r. Shift d is equal to t sin I minus r divided by cos r. T sin I minus r divided by cos r. For the proof is there, you can check in the notes. T sin I minus r by cos r. Where T is the thickness of the glass slab and I and r is the angle of incidence and angle of refraction. So this is about the lateral shift point of view. Next, total internal reflection and a critical angle. Critical angle, when the light ray going from denser to rarer medium at a certain angle of incidence and angle of refraction becomes 90. The light ray passing from optically denser medium to rarer medium. Light ray incident like this. The angle of incidence I see. Then if the light ray passing along the interface between the two medium and angle of refraction is 90, far is 90. Then in such a case, the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle. Okay, and the light ray passing from optically denser to rarer medium. For such a angle of incidence, if the angle of refraction is 90 degree, that means if the light ray grazes along the interface, then the angle of incidence I see is called critical angle. Okay. Then therefore the refractiveness of the denser medium with respect to the rarer medium, you can write as n is equal to 1 by sin c. Is the relation. How it is came? Sin I c by sin r. Sin r is sin 90 is equal to, this here, n for denser medium, 1 is for rarer medium. Then you write n by, from denser to rarer, no? You should write 1 by n. Opposite side is 1 by n. Sin 91, then n is equal to 1 by sin ic. Is the formula. Relation between refractive index and critical angle. Next important point, when the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, that means some of the light ray incident like this, this I is greater than IC. The light ray passing from denser to rarer and the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, then the light ray comes back to the same medium. It will comes back like this. After refraction, that is a reflection happen. This phenomenon is called TIR, total internal reflection. Okay, when the light ray comes from, what is the conditions for TIR? Ray must travel from denser to rarer medium. Angle of incidence greater than the critical angle. Then in that case, the light ray comes back to the same medium. And the critical angle depends upon the wavelength lambda. That is inversely proportional to index, that is sin c. Common example for TIR is, for examples are looming, mirage, brilliance of the diamond, optical fiber. These are about the applications or examples of TIR. అంటే క్రిటికల్ యాంగిల్. ఆ రిక్లేదిస్ అప్ టు దిస్ రీక్యాప్. ఓకే
yes sir.
Yeah, remaining that recap document I'll share now in the group. You can go through. Now it is time up, 8 o'clock. Okay, you can start practicing. Remaining document I'll share, recap document.
Thank you, sir.